Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to wrap a custom texture around highly realistic 3D text with reflections, refractions, and deep shadows. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, hit that small subscribe button at the lower right corner. If my tutorials have helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, and you would like to help support my channel, become a channel member or become a patron through Patreon. To become a channel member, click the join button below this video, or to become my patron, click the Patreon card at the upper right. Both of them will give you early access to watch my new tutorials a week before anyone else can see them. You'll also get a 10% discount on all Blue Lightning TV merch. All right, let's get started to create our 3D text. Keep in mind, this tutorial is for version CS6 and later. Download the Photoshop template I provided. Its link is in my video's description or project files. You'll most likely get a pop-up message that says you don't have the font that's in this template. No problem. Just replace it with any text you like or download the font I'm using. The font is called Gunplay, and I provided its link as well. The template contains three layers: the text, a rusted texture image that we'll use for our background, and a metal texture that we'll use to wrap our text with. We're going to create this image that has the metal texture wrapping around the text and the rust texture as the background. However, if you want to reverse the textures, use the alternative Photoshop document I provided. The first step is to check our 3D preferences. Go to Edit, Preferences, and 3D. The ray tracer threshold determines the quality of the rendering. The higher the threshold, the less noise you'll see in your final image, but the longer it'll take to render. The default amount is 5. For slower computers, you may want to use a lower setting. VRAM is your video card's memory. The amount I'm allowing Photoshop to use is not necessarily what you should use because your computer may have its own requirements. Go to View, Show, and make sure the top four 3D elements are checked. If any aren't, just click them. Shift-click the metal texture to make it active as well, and go to 3D, New Mesh from Layer, and Postcard. If you see this message, just click Yes. If you can't access the 3D feature, it may be due to one or more of the reasons I listed in the video's description. I won't be going over every aspect of 3D in this tutorial, since I already did an in-depth tutorial of it. If you'd like to watch it, its link is also in my video's description below. Next, we'll set up the metal texture to wrap around our text. To do this, make the metal texture layer active and open the 3D panel. Click the whole scene's icon and click Metal Texture. In the Properties panel, under Materials, click the arrow next to the ball, click the gear icon, and click New Material. When you see this window, click OK to save it. Scroll down to see that metal texture is now a new material preset. Before we can wrap our text with this material, we need to make our text go into a 3D mode. Open the Layers panel and make your text active. Go to 3D and New 3D Extrusion from Selected Layer. If we ever want to backtrack a number of steps, it's a good idea to use the History panel to do it. Go to Window, and if History isn't checked, click it to open the panel. Just go to the step we want to take our project back to and click it. Click the front inflation material to make it active, and shift-click the back inflation material to make all the text layers active. Open the materials preset and click Metal Texture. Instantly, it wraps this material around our entire text. Click the extrusion material layer and make the reflection 35%. You can always adjust it later. Click the Meshes icon and reduce the depth of the extrusion to 1 inch. Again, you can change it later if you like. Click the Coordinates icon and in the X axis of the rotation field, type in 90 degrees and press Enter or Return. Go to the Secondary View window and open the Select View Camera list. Make sure Top is checked and click the Swap Main and Secondary View icon, which does what it says, swapping both views. Go to 3D and move object to ground plane. Now our text is sitting directly on the background. We'll center it in a minute. Open the Layers panel and shift-click the Rust background to make it active as well. Go to 3D and merge 3D layers. This connects our text with the background in 3D space. Open the 3D panel and click the Whole Scenes icon again. Click Environment and uncheck IBL, which are image-based lights. Your image will probably look black. If it is, it just means that presently there are no lights illuminating your image. Click the light bulb icon and the small light bulb icon at the bottom of the panel. This opens a list of 3D lights you can choose to illuminate your image: point, spot, or infinite. You can add as many lights as you like from these three choices. Click New Infinite Light. The light widget has a handle you can rotate to adjust the angle of the light source. To soften the shadow, increase the softness to 30%. You can always adjust it later. To brighten your image, increase the intensity to 175%. Next, we'll center our text over the background. Click the Whole Scene icon and make sure your overall text is active. Click the Coordinates icon and place your cursor over the Y-axis of the position field. Drag to the right or left until your text is centered. Next, we'll reduce the size of our text because we'll be ultimately zooming into our entire image. Go to the Z-axis of the scale field and drag it to the left until your text is approximately this size. Click Current View. Click the Rotate icon and rotate your image to an angle you like. Click the Scale icon and drag your image down until your image fills the document. If you want to drag your image in any direction, click the Drag icon and, as before, drag your cursor. Remember, you're free to adjust any aspect of your image. For example, if you want to add a bevel to your text, no problem. Click your text layer to make it active and click the Cap icon. Open the Contour presets. I'll pick Cove Deep, however, feel free to experiment with the other presets. I'll make the bevel width 10% and the angle minus 10 degrees. I'll make the inflate angle 0%. Now that I see it, I think I'd like to widen the width of the bevel. I'll go back and increase it to 20%. To get a preview of the final image, click the Render icon and Photoshop will start rendering the 3D image. If you decide you want to stop the rendering to make some adjustments, just press the Escape key on your keyboard. Remember, it can take anywhere from a few minutes to many hours. At the bottom left of your screen, you'll see a countdown timer letting you know the time remaining for Photoshop to complete the rendering. When it finishes rendering, it'll automatically stop. To save the final 3D image, open the Layers panel and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Alt-Control-Shift-E or Option-Command-Shift-E on a Mac, then press Control or Command-Shift-S and save the layer as a JPEG. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.